Barak to all this, mashallah, beautiful faces. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it the best Ramadan for you and your family and your loved one. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of you. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you and bless your family and bless your our communities. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for our Muslim ummah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us and to give us prosperity and success and health to establish Ramadan in the best way, the way of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet ﷺ said about Taraweeh, this is Taraweeh. It was not actually called Taraweeh at the time of the Prophet ﷺ. It was called Qiyam. The Prophet ﷺ used to pray every night of the whole year, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is our way back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The minute his name is mentioned, we have to say sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is just the minimum we can do. He used to pray every night sallallahu alaihi wasallam for long hours, even though he is the best human being, even though he won the best prize in Jannah. So his wife asked him, why? Why are you exhausting yourself so much that you can't stand? You have to really collapse after praying. Not like us, just 1 hour. No, he will, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, I'm just being grateful. I'm praying, thanking Allah. From my heart, I'm standing there, saying, Allah, thank you so much for Islam. Thank you so much, you give me the honor to speak your words. To say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Allah is speaking to us. Can you imagine this? Every minute you stand and say Allahu Akbar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself turn his face to your face. And the minute you say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Allah tell the angels by your name, Hamidani Abdi. Abdul Rauf says, thank you Allah. Hafiz says, thank you Allah. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Malik, every word you say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeat with you. So the scholars say, the best thing you can do in Ramadan is to pray. The best thing you can do in Ramadan is to pray, even if you pray with Qul Huwallahu Ahad. Even if you only know Qul Huwallahu Ahad, just pray with that. But go for it. Go for 2-3 hours. The Prophet ﷺ used to pray like that every single night. But in Ramadan, one Ramadan, he prayed in the masjid. The first night of Ramadan at night time, he does his qiyam in the masjid. Some Sahaba saw him, they joined in. The Messenger ﷺ was praying. Can you imagine this? How lucky they were. Mentioning his name, it's an honor for us. Just saying the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is nothing to increase him. It's actually increasing us in honor. It brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So imagine how lucky those who saw him, who ate with him, who walked with him, he laughed with him, traveled with him. When he prayed, they prayed with him. And when he says walad dalin, they say ameen. So when he finished, he looked around and found, whoa, where you came from? This is the Masjid Nabawi. Second night in Ramadan, the number was tripled. The third night of Ramadan, the Masjid was full. The fourth night of Ramadan, the whole area around the Masjid was crowded, but the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not come out. The whole Masjid was packed and outside, and because everybody told everybody, the messenger's praying, everybody's coming. He did not come out of his house. They waited for hours. He didn't come out. Second night, they told him, O Messenger of Allah, why didn't he come last night? We want you to pray the whole night. We want you to lead Taraweeh the whole night. He says, I was worried if I pray, it would become obligatory in you. It will become a must, and it won't be easy for so many of you. So he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, feeling for us and caring for us, did not want to pray together. Afraid that revelation will come and say, Taraweeh is a must. But after the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, passed away, there's no chance now that revelation will come down. There's no more revelation. So Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiallahu anhu, he says, look, what we were, the messenger was worried about, was worried that Taraweeh will become obligatory. Now there is no way. Let's do Taraweeh together. And he called Ubay ibn Ka'b, the most amazing voice of Quran, to lead the Taraweeh. And he put the first time ever lights in the masjid of the Prophet. And this with Taraweeh instead of Qiyam, because they used to sit like us and rest in between. They read two rak'ah, and then they sit down, do dhikr, do dua, have a drink, have some food, and then they continue. This is why it's called Taraweeh, it means having a rest. Mm-hmm. And the best rest you can have, sitting in the masjid, mentioned by Allah, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no group of Muslims sit together in the masjid talking about Allah, except Allah will mention their name. And He will send angels especially for that task, to bless the gathering. And He will send sakina and tranquility and peace on them. And after they finish the gathering, it will be said to them, قُومُوا مَغْفُورًا لَكُمْ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us forgiven. Get up, stand again, all your sins are forgiven. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all our mistakes. Amen. Ramadan, the do and don't in Ramadan quickly, inshallah. Again, just a reminder, and reminders for me is more beneficial than you. Number one, the do. Do more sadaqah in Ramadan. The best sadaqah I can do, it's in Ramadan. Al-abdu fi dhill sadaqatihi yawm al-qiyamah. You will be standing in your own private garden in the day of judgment because of your sadaqah. Even though everybody else is standing in a queue which is long, 50,000 years long. And you will be comfortable. You will be having a shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a drink from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sadaqah Ramadan, the best sadaqah ever. Do inshallah. Sadaqah. And Quran. This is the month of Jibreel came down with the Quran. This is the month of Quran. Listen to Quran. Watch some lectures about the meaning of the Quran. Read some Quran. Whatever you can do, but just make it a habit every day of the month. Come to the masjid. Taraweeh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, if you pray Taraweeh with the Imam, Allah will give you the reward as if you prayed the whole night. Not only 1 hour, it will be 12 hours reward. And this is what we're standing here in line. It's a practice for standing in front of Allah in the day of judgment. We are standing here willingly. We stand here in humility. We stand here without choice. In Akhirah, there's no choice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember that. We stood here by our choice and He will honor us in Akhirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our stand before Him honoring for us and for our family. So Ramadan is the month of the masjid. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, if any of you make wudu and come to the masjid for a farida, coming for Maghrib, coming for Isha, coming for Asr, it will be rewarded as if you've gone for Hajj. And every step will raise your rank in Jannah. Every step will give you a good deed. Every step will wipe away a mistake. This is in the normal days. Imagine Ramadan. The Prophet ﷺ say, بَشِّرِ الْمَشَّائِينَ فِي الظُّلَمِ إِلَى الْمَسَاجِدِ بِالنُّورِ التَّامِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Say congratulations to those who go to the masjid in the dark, that they will have full light in Akhirah. The brothers and sisters, the grave has no light, except to the light of our good deed. The grave, no matter how rich you are, no matter how smart you are, no matter how popular you are, it's all the same. But for the believers, it will be the peace of paradise. And this is our investment. Come to the masjid in the dark, Allah will give you the full light in the grave, the full light in Jannah. It's Ramadan. Come to the masjid. This is another do in Ramadan. Come to the masjid for Fajr. Brothers and sisters are exempted from that. They can pray at home. It's better for the sisters to pray at home. But brothers, young and old, come for Fajr. It's easy now. You're awake anyway. You're awake for suhoor anyway. The Prophet ﷺ said, the two rak'ah sunnah of Fajr. Not the Fajr itself. The two rak'ah sunnah of Fajr, more valuable than anything you can achieve in this life. خَيْرٌ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. It's more valuable than anything you can ever achieve, just the sunnah. There's no amount you can put on the fard itself. This is Ramadan. And tasahharu, the Prophet ﷺ said, Ramadan, do, have suhoor. No matter how small it is, wake up and have suhoor. The Prophet ﷺ said, tasahharu fa inna fi suhoori barakah. There's a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you waking up at that part of the night. Another hadith is, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى الْمُتَسَحِّرِينَ. Allah and all His angels will bless those who have suhoor. You're waking up from sleep for Allah. Who does that? Only Muslim. Alhamdulillah, Allah chose us to be Muslim. Allah chose us to stand in prayer. Allah chose us to fast for Him. So this is an honor for us. It's not a burden. We should be so happy and proud with every good deed. Allah says, فَبِذَٰلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. The Muslim should be enjoying fasting, enjoying coming to the masjid, enjoying giving sadaqah. Enjoying. The Prophet asked Umar and asked Abu Bakr, مَاذَا أَبْقَيْتَ لَهُمْ. He says, what did you leave your family? Not like us, what did he give to the masjid? He didn't say, what did he give? He said, what did he leave? SubhanAllah, none of us would like that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and forgive us and increase our rank in dunya and akhirah. So Ramadan, do be with Allah, do with dhikr. Do with dhikr, don't speak anything except it's a good deed. If it, what you're saying is zero, not good deed, not a bad deed, who likes zero? Who likes to work for nothing? Nobody likes to work for nothing. Either work for a good deed, which is remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Somebody's annoying you, say, Inni sa'im, inni sa'im. I'm fasting, I'm praying. It's like a prayer. I'm in ibadah. I can't speak like this. I can't watch this. I can't listen to this. I can't, you know, look at that. So, during the day and during the night. It's not that once we have iftar at Maghrib finish Ramadan. No. Even the night, وَلِلَّهِ عُتَقَاءٌ مِنَ النَّارِ وَذَلِكَ كُلِّ لَيْلَةٍ. Every single night of Ramadan, Allah gave a scorecard to some Muslim. Here is your Jannah ticket. You should be one of them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us from them.
Yeah?
Ramadan, don't. So these are the do. Don't get angry. Don't get angry. It's hungry, not angry. And this have an accent, you become hungry. Hungry, angry man. No. Especially brothers at home, don't be angry because of the food is not ready. Don't be angry because of whatever your favorite is not made. No. It's Ramadan, brothers. It's Ramadan, it's not about eating. Don't force your family to cook so much, brothers and sisters. It's not Ramadan spirit. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam have never had, never, ever, all his life, two types of food in the same meal. Never. His wife says, "Ma shabi'a al Muhammad." So the family of Muhammad never were full of good food. They were never full, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he is the best human being. He was offered the treasure of dunya and akhirah and live forever. And he says, "No, bala rafiq al-al. I would love to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." So don't be angry. Don't be angry. And another one, don't gossip. Don't talk about anybody. Don't dint and lose your reward. In Ramadan, if somebody come to talk to you about somebody, put your fingers in your ear. It's a sunnah. Did you know that sunnah? It's a sunnah. The Prophet ﷺ, when somebody come to talk to him, the minute they mention a name of somebody else, he put his finger in his ear and says, leave my chest clear for my brother. Leave my chest clear. Even if you don't believe the story, it affects you. We're all human beings. Don't talk about anybody, even the kuffar, leave them alone. Make dua for them, may Allah guide them. It would be more beneficial if Allah guided them. So make dua for them. The Prophet ﷺ was told, but Abu Huraira, my mother is cursing you. Abu Huraira says to the Prophet, my mother is cursing you. He raised his hand and says, Allahumma ahdi umma Abu Huraira. Oh Allah, guide umma. He didn't curse, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Jews used to say, death to you, Muhammad. Assalamu alaykum. Death to you. And he used to say, alaykum. One half word. Even though Aisha is replying, he says, don't reply. Abu Bakr was sitting, radiallahu anhu, and people are cursing Abu Bakr. And Abu Bakr is not saying anything. The minute he replied, the Prophet walked away. He walked away. He was upset, Abu Bakr. He says, oh, they keep fighting and cursing me for half an hour. And he's sitting down. The minute I say, don't, you walked away. He says, yeah, because when you're not replying, the angels are replying on your behalf. The angels are blessing you. The minute you reply, Shaitan is coming. And I don't sit in a place where Shaitan is fighting and heating the argument. So brothers, this is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive every day and every night. But if we don't forgive, how can we accept Allah to forgive us? How we expect Allah to forgive us? We need to forgive. We need to forgive for akhirah.
We need to forgive not because of the person we're forgiving, because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves it. Allah loves it. So please forgive. Please make dua for the ummah. Please just reconcile. Please don't get angry. Please don't forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this month. The day and night. It's only ayyam ma'dudat. It's only ayyam ma'dudat. Ramadan started already. Ramadan started already. This is the chance. Wallahi, wallahi, the people, in the Muslim in the grave, they will wish for 1 second of Ramadan. 1 second to say Allahumma innaka afu tuhibbu al-afwa afu anna. 1 second to say La ilaha illallah. 1 second to come to the masjid. 1 second to make dua. So we are alive. We are blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to make every possible moment count. Your work, your study is a good deed. So don't just put your effort at work. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Put your energy in study. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. So even the sisters who are cooking, sisters are standing in the kitchen, wallahi, everybody that eat from your food gets give you a reward. Their fasting, copy of the reward for fasting come to the sisters. So don't belittle that. Don't say, I'm cooking all day, I'm working all day, I'm studying all day. Count it as a good deed. Do ihtisab. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward you. And while at work, while in the bus, while in the train, the only time you can do is to do dhikr and to do dua. The Prophet said, Alhamdulillah, tamla al-mizan. Just saying Alhamdulillah, it will fill the scale of your good deed. So we need to busy ourselves all the time by saying Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. For the good deed, think of the family and say Alhamdulillah. Think of your health, Alhamdulillah. Think of your job, Alhamdulillah. Look around and say Alhamdulillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us grateful. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it the best Ramadan for all of us. Amen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all our families. Amen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to answer our dua. Amen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to help others. Amen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to use us to serve the deen. Amen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our shortcoming. Amen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us Laylat al-Qadr. Allahumma arzuqna Laylat al-Qadr. اللهم ارزقنا ليلة القدر واجعلنا فيها من العتقاء يا رب العالمين وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.